Living Seed Media brings to you God's Word, which is His comprehensive equipment for changing lives. May the Lord impact your heart as you encounter His Word. For further inquiry or counsel, contact Peace House, P.O. Box 971, Boko, Benue State, Nigeria. Telephone numbers 0703-036-3659, 0703-768-1198. Email address lsmedia@livingseed.org or visit our website at www.livingseed.org. Let us sit back and listen as the servant of God brings forth the word of life.
I want you now to join me as I read 1 Samuel chapter 4 and verse 9. Be strong and quit yourselves like men. O ye Philistines, that you be not servants unto the Hebrews as they have been to you. Quit yourselves like men. Fight. When the Philistines had a wind that the God of the Hebrews had descended, they did something that turned their story. Though later on they discovered that there was nothing in the shout of the children of Israel, they discovered that even their dreaded ark, they can easily capture it. Even though they discovered that the stories of the mighty God of Israel that they have heard had become evaporated. Nevertheless, they did not take chances. And what I intend for us to charge ourselves with here tonight are the practical issues that the Philistines, the uncircumcised, the children of this world, how they seem to be wiser than the children of the kingdom of God. Since the word of God had said in different places, it said, go ye and learn a lesson from the ant. If there is a lesson to learn from the ant and God is directing his children to go and learn. If he had at a time said, go to the house of the potter and watch the man who is making a pot, if there is something to learn from them. I do not think that there's anything wrong if the Holy Spirit asks us to peep into the kingdom of darkness and see what they are doing. And if there's any lesson to learn that will be of advantage for the purpose of God, it is not strange for us to look at the strategy of the Philistines. That's why I perceive this Bible verse was left in this passage as an admonition, as an instruction to those of us that God has placed in position of leadership. And I want you to note that they spoke clearly to themselves. They did not mince words among themselves, and I thought that what they said and the way they said it and the issues they raised, they were strong enough for us to pick our own lesson. Number one, when they said be strong, I hope you know that the word be strong is not exclusive to them. As God said to us before, be strong. Is there passages in the Bible where you hear the Holy Spirit say, be strong? Be strong. Be strong in the Lord. Whenever you come to any matter of spiritual warfare, the first word you will hear, say, fear not. Be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. As you go this night, I charge you in the name of the Lord, do what? Be strong. Even though the matter looks hopeless, even though the challenges look overwhelming and is actually depressing, I hear the Holy Spirit saying, be strong, be strong. The Philistines, when they heard the big noise, the way the earth was shaking because the children of Israel really shouted, because they thought that their victory came. And the Philistine looked left and right and said, we are finished. We are finished. We are finished. You know what came to their mind immediately? They began to remember how the children of Israel, when God was with them, it's that same ark they carried, and they were moving around the wall of Jericho. How the walls of Jericho fell flat. They remembered. They remembered how the king of Bashan, how the king of Moab, how they were trembling when they saw the children of God coming, the host. They remember how the Pharaoh of Egypt learned his lesson. And from that time to today, Egypt could never stand against Israel because they learned their own lesson. They remembered. And the Philistines say, if it is the God of the Hebrews that have come down, we are finished. But let's do something before whatever he has come to do. What did they say to themselves? Be what? Be strong. Unfortunately, listen, they said be strong, but they did not say be strong in the Lord. Not just saying be strong, but we are saying to you that there is God with us. So brothers and sisters, as you rise from here, be what? Be strong in the Lord. We will not lose the battle in the name of Jesus Christ. Even though, as we are looking at various things, as we took the last report about what people have done in education and all of this, the whole thing is looking as if, hey, these people have gone far. Can we catch up with them? I want to inform you tonight, be strong in the Lord. When Brother David came back to his camp and found that the Amalekites have come in, they have raided everywhere, they have burned down the house, they have taken away his children, they have taken away their wives, and he wept and wept and wept. And he said, Lord, what do I do? God said, wipe off your face. He said, should I pursue them? He said, yes. Will I overtake them? He said, you will. Will you recover all? He said, yes. I want to say to you as we rise from here, there is hope for us. We are not going to end in shame. Say, I will build my church and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. But nevertheless, he said, be strong. Be strong. Whereas the Philistines mobilized and said, they said, be strong. They were talking about be strong in your muscle, be strong in your wisdom, be strong in your strategy. But they lacked the fact of being strong in the Lord. And if they were only standing up and mobilizing their strength, and they got the kind of result they got, how much more will it be when we rise to be strong in the Lord who never fails? So you are going to help me tell the person by your side, say, dear brother, be strong in the Lord. God has not brought you to leadership to disgrace you. Be strong in the Lord. And what did they say to them the next time? And quit yourselves like men, O ye Philistines. And the first thing that struck me is that, look at Philistines. They are calling themselves back and say, look, quit yourself as men, O Philistines. I don't know whether you like, you understand the meaning of that. But, you know, in my local language, when you want to mobilize and somebody wants you to wake up to the reality of who you are you hearing me? He calls you by your, not only by your native name, but by your father's name and by the heroic name of your family. I remember some time when something is going wrong and somebody will just call you and call you by your name and say, never you forget the son of whom you are. You have a name that cannot be disgraced. You can't give up. Sometime when I'm watching all of those things, somebody will just say, Emioma Akani. You know what he's trying to say like that? Say, I cannot. My father has never been known to be disgraced. Not now will I be disgraced. And I saw the Philistines saying something, say, quit yourself as men, all Philistines. You know what they mean? They meant that we Philistines, we are strong, we are giants, we don't give up. It doesn't matter how many times battles came, we don't give up because it is not in our nature to give up. All Philistines. And I was wondering how that song say, rise up, all men of God. There's a name that God has given us, the name of Jesus. And that name has been placed on our head. We are children of the Most High. We are servants of the Most High God. We are not ordinary servants. We are not ordinary men. We are not ordinary women. We are not people that are just managing and struggling to survive. We serve a living God. So they said to themselves, quit yourself as men, oh you Philistines. As if they forgot that they were Philistines. As if they forgot that that is who they were. They called themselves back to action. Can I ask you this night? Don't forget your identity. Don't go out of this place as if you are a mere man. Has God not said, call upon me in the time of trouble, I will answer you? Has God not said, I will not leave you, I will not forsake you, and I will not disgrace you? Has he not said, those that are called by my name? So I want to charge you this night. Be strong in the Lord and quit yourself. You know the meaning of quit yourself? Wake up yourself. Mobilize yourself. And he said, oh ye Philistines. And I don't know which name you will like to attach to yourself this night. But I was going to have said, oh army of the Most High God. The Lord of hosts is our captain. As you rise from here, I want you to know what heaven has been waiting for is just for you to arise. God has just been waiting to get you to stand up, for him to get someone to back up. If you go now and you make a decree in the name of the Lord, it shall be established. Those things that look as if it's impossible, those Jordan that have been overflooded, step on it, it will break in the name of the Lord. You are not going in your name, you are not going in your strength, you are not going by your energy. You are going in the name of the Lord. I was going to remind you. It was David, when he was going to confront the Goliath. You remember? When Goliath has gathered and he's talking here and he's talking here and he's stretching his hand here and there and it looked as if he has finished everybody. And Saul and all his own servants, because they let their God, they were all hiding in the cave. And did you know what they were saying? They were saying, this Goliath, he's an experienced man of war. He's very tall, 9 cubits. He has 6 toes, 24 toes altogether. And that the weight of his spear, you know, they were describing it to David. When David was going to arise, do you know what he said? He said, who is this uncircumcised Philistine? You see, that's spiritual warfare. All others saw him as a giant. All others saw him as a man of experience and expert in war. All others saw his toes and his bronze and his armor and his armor bearer and all the things with which he dressed to come. But this brother said, who is this uncircumcised Philistine? Do you know the meaning of that? This is a man that has no God. This is a man that has no covenant. This is a man that has nothing, nothing at all. Who is this? Who is this uncircumcised Philistine? Even though we are seeing the spread of the kingdom of darkness, and we have seen the decay that has visited us, even though we have seen everything as if the church any moment from now is going to disappear, I want to inform you, our captain says, the gate of hell shall not prevail against the church. Our captain says, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, do what? Go in my name. As you are rising from this meeting, never you forget who you are. Never you forget whose son you are, whose delegate you are, whose ambassador you are. And when David said, this uncircumcised Philistine, why is he defiling? Did you notice that he didn't say he was defiling Israel? What did he say? Why is he defiling the armies of who? Of the living God. He was resetting the agenda. As you are rising from this meeting, go and reset the agenda. Those things that look so intimidating, speak unto them. They will shift. The whole of heaven has been waiting for a bold man. When God said to Joshua, only be strong and be courageous. That's all you need. You don't need anything else. You just need to be bold. And they said to them, oh ye Philistines, as if there's something in being a Philistine. As if there's something in being a Philistine. So they say, oh ye Philistines. Oh my God. If I were preaching Yoruba now, I would have changed. You would have heard me say, if you are not bastards. That's what they said to themselves. If you are genuine Philistines, you cannot become a slave to Hebrews. Did you hear that? He said, no. You can't be a slave to Hebrews. Hebrews are our slaves from time immemorial, and they will be our slaves. And I was trying to find out how many years were the children of Israel a slave of the Philistines before. But when they are mobilizing themselves, see what they are saying, very bogus. They have been our slaves, you cannot become their slave. Where we call head, you don't step on the ground with it. That's what they are saying. Can I ask you? Are we just ordinary Philistines? Eh? Who are we? Servants of the Most High. This is the host of the Lord. And our captain is not a mere man. Our commander is he who never loses a battle. All that he has been waiting is for you to arise. I'm trusting God that as you take personal decision to arise and to go from this meeting, you will return with great reports. You will be calling us and say, Brother Gbile, as I took a step, I saw doors opening. I saw mountains melting. I saw hills coming down. I saw impossible situation becoming possible. I can see the glory of God breaking forth in our churches. So will it be in the name of Jesus Christ. Now they said to themselves, these are people that have no God. These are uncircumcised people that don't have any covenant relationship. They are aliens to the commonwealth of Israel. They have no God to call on to. Me, I can call on God and he will answer. There's no God of Philistines that can answer. Yet see what they said to themselves. That ye be not servants unto the Hebrews. As they have been to you, quit yourselves like men and do what? And fight. If men that have no hope, if men that have no covenant, if men that have no God, if men that have nothing, that even their tallest man, when David arose and told his own people and said, look, don't worry, leave me, send me, I'm going to face this man. Saul said, hey, no, you're a young man, you're a young boy, you don't know this thing. This man has been fighting since his youth. That's what has defeated them. When you forget your God, you hand over victory, unnecessarily, undeserved victory to the enemy. It's not that the Philistines are tall, it's not that anything, there's nothing in Islam that could overrun the work of God here. But because we have forgotten who we are, and we have forgotten whose we are. Did you hear two things I've said? We have forgotten who you are and whose you are. You have treated yourself as one orphan that has no one to call. And whenever there's any need, we would rather be using our telephone to call men here and there. We think that our help comes from abroad. And so I say, if only I can just get some people abroad to come and support something. What do you mean by that? Say, every good gift, every perfect gift, where does it come from? It's from above, not from abroad. Men that have no God, see how they are charging themselves. When David said, no, I'll go against this uncircumcised Philistine. So, sir, but you can't go. You have not known anything. You have not been trained. And this man has been trained since his youth. You can't match him. Even me, the king of Israel, the tallest king, you know, I can't stand there. That's why I'm hiding here. In the past 6 weeks, he has been abusing my mother, abusing my father. Hey, we can't go. You see, that's the problem. Please. And the young man said, no. Can I tell you something? I was in the field. We with my father's sheep. And a lion came, a lion. Very, very voracious lion that wanted to kill the animal. And I looked up and I said, oh God, the great shepherd of Israel, I cannot lose this sheep. What did I do? I rushed at the lion. And I grabbed the lion by his neck. And I tore it. And I rescued my father's sheep. The Lord who delivered me from the mouth of the lion. We hand over this uncircumcised Philistine also to my hand. He said, and if you are not understanding, at another day, another bear came. Another dangerous, terrible animal came. And he was just latching on my sheep. He was already cutting the neck. I said, no, I can't carry a dead sheep back home for my father. I ran after the bear. I caught it, I tore it, and I rescued my sheep. Can you imagine that these people, that the Philistines are shouting at, are they of less value than ordinary sheep? This is the army of the Lord. Did you see him now? He changed the narrative. He said, this is the army of the Lord whom he has come to defile. It's uncircumcised Philistine, I'm going there. They say, can you wear this dress? Excuse me, I've not tried that before. I'm not going with all these weapons of iron. There's an invisible weapon I'm wearing already. It's the invisible but invincible mighty weapon that God had given me. I'm going. I go in the name of the Lord. Can you remember what he said? When Philistine, Goliath stood up there and said, am I a dog that you are coming to me with sling and stone? He lied. He said, are you unreasonable? Brother David did not allow him to keep quiet. What did he say? He said, you have come to me with what? With spear, with bow, with arrow, with chariots, but I have come to you in the name of the Lord, whom thou defilest. And this day, the Lord will hand you over to my hand, and I will offer your body to the birds of the air, and they will come and make a feast today. Can you imagine? Is that an empty boast? He was talking as a man who knew whom he carried. So when the Philistines were mobilizing, I said, quit yourself like men as Philistines and fight. David knew that all their shout is the shout of uncircumcised, and there's no God in their midst. So I come to you in the name of the Lord. And God will hand you over to me. And while the man was still doing like this, David ran towards him. And he took his kanakana. He took his catapult. And he did like this. Just one smooth stone. One smooth stone. Even when we went to hunt for birds in those days, we don't use smooth stone. We look for very sharp stone that if it hit it, at least it will wound it and pile it down. But now he got smooth stone, very smooth, and he carried it. He wasn't depending on stone. He was depending on God, who drives smooth stones into the head of a wicked man. Can you imagine? So when he did like this, the Philistine was still wondering, what is he trying to do? Does he not see my helmet? Does he not see my breastplate? Does he not see the shield? Does he not see this? Does he not see that? Does he not see that? Where can stone enter? How can stone penetrate iron that I'm standing? Are you foolish? He was still imagining when the invisible hand of the Almighty God drove the stone to his very forehead and the thing entered and sank. And before you know it, He fell down unconscious and he just scattered, baga! And David, who had no sword in his hand, he rushed there. He collected the sword of the Philistine and used the sword of the Philistine to do what? To finally slaughter him and cut his head. He cut his head. He carried the head. Uburia Janaku. He carried the head of Philistine. And as he was coming back with the head of Goliath, with the sword of Goliath, what happened? All the Philistines, they began to run. And David said, no, don't let them escape. Run after them. Deal with them. God has handed them over to us. And that's how Philistines were dying. Twer, as if they are nothing. Because God has found a man who is ready to stand. As you go from this meeting, we do not serve a God that can be put to shame. God has not called us to put us to shame. He has called us to glory and to virtue. He's only waiting for you to stand up. And that song says, rise up, O men of God. They were telling themselves, rise up, O ye Philistines. What is in Philistines that they are telling themselves to rise? If not because the children of God have left their own armor. Do you remember that it was these same Philistines that Jonathan, him alone with his armor bearer, went to their garrison, went to their whole barrack. And these Philistines were looking at them and saying, these Hebrews, they're even coming out of their caves. And let them come here. We discipline them. They didn't know that Jonathan had said, it is nothing with God to save either with plenty or with few. God does not need a whole army to do anything. If he decides to walk with us now, even me alone is enough for this garrison. But let's check whether God is going with us. If the people say, let them come down, we discipline them, it means God has handed them over to us. And they said that. That's how Jonathan, did you hear me? He just rolled down from the hill and fell down in their midst. And I was surprised that, look at a young man, he came and fell down. I thought Philistine would have used their long leg to do what? To trample and say, we told you not to come here. But I don't understand what happened. How the invisible power of the Almighty God began to operate. How the Philistines began to hear, I don't know what they were hearing. They started killing themselves. They started killing themselves. How can one man and his armor bearer fall into your camp, a whole barrack, and you are all shivering? There must be something there. But you see, can you imagine how many weeks the children of Israel have been panting under Saul? When Jonathan said, let us even go. If it is to die, let's go and die. If God was going to hand them over to us, let's even just try. You see, and he took a step like that and see what God did that day. What is God waiting for, please? What is God waiting for? Action. Both leaders who say, let me go there. Let me go and attempt it. Let me trust God. As you rise to go from this meeting, you might be surprised that all that God has been waiting for is for you to arise. You will be surprised that all that God wants to do is just to see a man he can back up. And so the Bible said, and the Philistines fought. I'm telling you now, go and fight. What did I say? Go and do what? Fight for the Lord. Go and fight for this heritage. Fight on your knees in the place of prayer. Fight on the pulpit by declaring the word of the Lord without fear. Fight by taking time. Go out of your comfort zone. Go and stand out there and you see God, who never disappoints those who stand for him. He will rise up on our behalf. At this moment, I will ask you to rise. To rise. To rise. It doesn't matter all that the enemy thought he has collected. Our God is able to restore unto us all that the canker worms and the palmer worms have taken. You're going to stand and say, Lord, I will arise. I will arise. I am a man of God. You called me. I'm doing away with lesser things. I'm putting aside inconsequential issues. I'll give my heart, my soul, my mind, and my strength to serve the King of Kings. Lord, I will arise and I will go. The day of brotherhood has come again, when we stand shoulder to shoulder to end the night of wrong. Forth in your name, O Lord, I go. My daily labor to pursue. Forth, O Lord, in your name we go. We go to see you at work on the field of our call. Lord, I will arise. Are you there? Declare that. Tell the Lord that tonight I have heard you. The church has waited for you for this long. It has waited for leaders who are bold. Leaders who are going to take the battle to the gates. Leaders who are not going to play it safe. Leaders who are saying, God has put me here. And there's no one else again. The Moses that I could have been waiting for is now dead. Lord, I arise. As Joshua arose, River Jordan broke. As he arose, eternal things began to happen. We have said so many things that we want to rise up to go and do. I want you to enlist in the hand of God tonight and say, Lord, we rise in your name. We have said we are going to pursue our youth, the young generation. I want you to believe, God, that your little step will be multiplied by God. Your smooth stone will bring down the head of the giant in the name of Jesus. God may have given you an opportunity in your denomination. You are now the bishop, you are now the archbishop, and you have been put in charge of some very critical areas. As God said, you are now in charge of ministerial training. Has God given you space now to be the director of evangelism? Ah, what an opportunity. Rise up. The church will be set on fire very soon under your watch. Because he who is with you is greater than he that is in the world. Please commit yourself and say, Lord, I will arise. I will devote myself to the ministry of prayer and of the word of God. I will teach, I will preach until I see the move of God break forth again. The diocese, I want you to look at the diocese, the DCC where you are standing, the regional council that you are operating on. Look at the various places, the circuit where God has made you a presbyter. Will you lift up your voice today and say, oh God, I take over that place. Everything that is contrary to your will in that congregation and in that circuit and in that diocese, I stand here today. In that archdeaconry, I stand here today to take it over. Please look at all the Philistines shouting there. Say, these uncircumcised Philistines, the Lord will hand you over to me. Are you representing the Equa Church? Are you coming from the Koki? Has God made you an overseer, even in the Catholic? Has God given you opportunity to be one of those top men in the Anglican Communion? Oh, lift up your voice and say, I will arise. I will shine, for my light has come. The glory of the Lord has risen upon us. I can no longer lie down. Has God given you mappings of what He wants to do through your life? Rise up here tonight and say, God, I take my destiny by my hand. I'm going to fight until I see your glory established. I'm going to fight. I will fight for the kingdom of God. Thank you, Father. Finally, listen carefully to me tonight. I use some strange words, and some of you are wondering, are those the words of the Word of God? Yes, fight. Did you not hear Paul talking to Timothy? Fight the good fight of faith. Did he say something like that to Timothy? So if Philistines are telling themselves to fight, they have only borrowed the word from the original owner of it. Fight the good fight of faith. By the time Paul was ending his own life and ministry, he said, I have fought the good fight. A crown of glory is waiting for me. So now you are going to make a declaration. We are going to fight. We are going to fight for the heritage of the Lord. We are going to fight for the body of Christ. We are going to fight for that which Jesus shed his blood to buy. The enemy cannot take over it. All the lions, all the bear that has come, can you rise up now and run after them and grab them and say, three enough is enough. Look at the youth that have become disoriented in your congregation. Fight to bring them back now. I say, Father, you have made me an overseer. I will lose any. I will lose any. I will see revival, restoration, a bringing back in that congregation. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you this night. Lord, we commit ourselves to fight for the faith. We commit ourselves to fight. It's not a delay now. We are going now into fight to secure the heritage of the Lord. Some of our pastors have come from EYN, and you can see all the intimidation. Rise up tonight. The Lord is going to recover those places. The Lord is going to bring back those places. We spoke about the IDP people, all those thousands that are somewhere else. Can you lift up your voice and say, Father, we fight for the Gaza Hills. We fight for all the areas where the gospel used to be. And these men, these aliens, we will turn them to rout in the name of Jesus. Shaka Baba Kuto Robuskila. Thank you tonight. Thank you tonight. Thank you tonight. Thank you tonight. Thank you for hearing us. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, in your name we go. Lord, in your name we go. Now, brothers and sisters, as our final response to God, we will take hymn number 10 all together. Stand up. Stand up for Jesus. Ye soldiers of the cross, lift up his royal banner. It must not suffer loss. As you are singing that song, you are saying, not in my hand will this royal banner suffer loss. From victory to victory, you are leading me as part of your army. Till every foe is vanquished, and Christ is Lord indeed. Let's take the song together, and as we're singing it, please turn it to your personal declaration. I'm standing for Jesus. I'm standing. Sing it as soldiers. We're going to declare it to God as if all we're going in your name. In your name we go. In the name of Jesus.
Oh, stand up. Stand up for. Stand up for Jesus. Yes, soldiers of the cross. Hold it up. It's royal.
To stand for you. You silence the mouth of lions. You wrought miracles. Now, Lord, we go in your name. We are finished with lesser things. We will see your glory. We will see your church moving forward. We will see the dying fire rekindled. and we will see the kingdom of darkness sent back. We will end the night of wrong. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you for this night. As your servant go, confirm your word in their mouth. As you did for David. And Goliath, that was shouting yesterday, it became a dead log. His head was inside the hand of David. All those who trusted in him were all scattered, and they were slaughtered as if they were ordinary chicken. As your servant go, confirm your word with us. Places that have been a threat, as if they hold something. We see them uncircumcised. We see that there is no covenant for them. We see that they are without God in this world, and they are aliens to the commonwealth. Who are they? Who are you, O mountain, to stand against Zerubbabel? Who are you, O mountain? For it is written, it's not by power, it's not by might, but by my spirit, says the Lord. And this night we speak to you, O mountains. Flee, flee in the name of Jesus Christ. O you hills, skip, skip, skip like lambs in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we your servant, the apex clergy, from all these denominations, we stand in agreement that the church of Jesus in Nigeria will not go under. We stand in agreement, oh God, that your heritage in Nigeria will not be lost. We stand in agreement to declare, oh God, that all the souls of men that are getting disillusioned, they will see the fire of God again. We are going to see a fresh move of the Spirit in our land, in our churches, in our congregations, in the name of Jesus Christ. And now, Lord, unto you, who is able to keep, who is able to watch, who is able to perfect, do we commit your servants. Thou, O Lord, who never fails, who answers prayer. You said the sun will not smite you by day, nor the moon by night. Now, O Lord, we ask, turn your face upon us. Be gracious unto your servant, and confirm the words of your saints, and cause your great name to be glorified in the land of the living. And so, Father, unto you, O God, we commit ourselves. We commit ourselves, our lives, our health, everything, all that your children need. It was Samson's wife that told her husband, if God had wanted to kill us, he will not show us this thing. If you did not intend to use us, you will not have been wasting your time. We know that we have a stake in what is about to happen very soon. And so, Father, in keeping, you will keep us. In watching, you watch over us. No untimely death will come to any of us in the name of Jesus. No accident on our part in the name of Jesus.